Hello, this video is about VirtualBox. As I'm one of the first users since VirtualBox 6.0 is out since yesterday, I ran into a few problems and I am gonna share the solution. You may have seen all the videos that I've made about Xmonad. I'm gonna leave them because it's quite interesting as solution as well, but I found a more efficient solution to actually have a beautiful VirtualBox all using my 1920 pixels on 1080 pixels. We need to start from scratch. Your template, the workflow that I work with, needs to be something totally different than in 5.0. That's important to know that we have now an upgrade, an update, and it is about VirtualBox 6.0, and from now on my setup will be as follows. You decide if that works for you. So the workflow is make ourselves a template. Okay, go to Linux and go to Arch Linux 64 bits. Next, I have already a copy there. Let me delete everything. VirtualBox, you're out. That's that. And then that sounds like it's good. Next. And we have more or less 50-50 for memory, 16 gigabyte 8.8. So host and guest get 50-50. And I take more or less 25 to 30 gigabyte as a normal hard disk. You can do a lot with 30 gigabyte. Then now comes the things you need to change, what are different from VirtualBox 5. Go to your settings. You can go over all these steps here, but the main things you need to change are processor. This needs to go up 8 cores, 4 cores, 4, 4, 50, 50. Enable the PAIA, etc. What is it again? Physical address extension. So INXI will work. Then display, and here is the difference we need to be aware of. But since I have a template, one set, I can forget it, by so to speak. So 50-50 again. And here we have the issue where it all revolves around. A graphics controller sets its standard to VMS VGA. If that works for you, that's fine. If it doesn't, use VBox Vega VGA. That works for me. You can enable it or not enable it. I think there's no difference in it. Don't feel any difference. So I've been trying everything out here. You can, well, a lot of time went into it. You can just follow the guide here, the video, and see if this works for you. Otherwise, you'll have to go over all the possible choices here. This is going to be my setting from now on, VBox VGA, and for the rest I kept everything the same. Okay, this is the standard template setting that I'll use from now on, VirtualBox 6.0.